Welcome to the module on data management. Information systems and technology tools are able to collect and store vast amounts of data. Advanced practice nurses use data to make decisions that lead to new programs and program evaluation. Data warehouses are complex, retrospective collections of data that come from different sources. The electronic health record is one source of data generated by one or more encounters in a care delivery system, such as a group of clinics or a hospital system. This can provide data on patient demographics, medical problems, laboratory data, immunization data, and more. Administrative medical claims data is another source of data that includes information on claims submitted on a bill to a payer. There may also be data from devices used to monitor the patient during a care episode or remotely. Other data could be from health plans or the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or from state health departments. Good data requires standardized terminologies with a data dictionary so that everyone who is using the data understands the meaning. There are several standardized terminologies relevant to nursing practice, such as the Omaha system or NANDA. There are other standardized terminologies that are used by several professions. Some examples are SNOMED, Systemized Nomenclature of Medicine Clinical Terms, RX Norm, a normalized drug naming system, and ICD-10, which is used for reimbursement in the United States and is used to report mortality and morbidity worldwide. The Omaha system is a standardized classification system designed to document nursing practice across the continuum of care. In order to promote the exchange of data across different health information systems, HL7 has served as a standards developing organization for many years. The interoperability of health data has been a goal since the early 2000s. The Healthcare Information Technology Standards Panel has led the way to developing technical specifications to advance interoperability. It has not been easy to convince vendors to use the same standards for transmitting data. Two standards that are commonly used in clinical practice are Clinical Documentation Architecture, or CDA, and Fast Health Interoperability Resources, or FHIR. Data science, or data analytics, or big data, is a systematic way to answer important questions across large data sets. These questions are important in assessing outcomes of care and predicting risk factors. The amount of data being collected is enormous, especially when you include patient-generated data from personal devices. Some organizations, such as the Veterans Health Administration, have been collecting and storing data for a long time. Data can be stored as structured data, such as lab values, or as unstructured data, such as clinical notes. Data analysis allows for more personalized care or precision medicine, such as when breast cancer treatments can be personalized to specific gene types. Exploratory data analysis prepares and analyzes data to identify patterns or trends. Advanced practice nurses can request secondary data from a data warehouse based on the needs of their project or population. The data must be cleaned and defined. Missing data and outliers must be addressed. Data can then be analyzed and displayed using data visualization techniques in order to support a project proposal or demonstrate the outcome of a project. Data mining is the step where patterns are looked at from a set of data. There are several models of data mining. Data governance is a term used to describe a process by which the responsibility for data stewardship and data maintenance are described and assigned to specific departments within an organization. This process includes writing policies for accessing, managing, and using data. Besides concerns about the privacy of data, issues of governance concern the ownership and access to data in order to manage the collection, storage, and appropriate use of this data for secondary research.